Everyone, welcome to my channel. So today I am super excited to finally share with all of you my Pat McGrath rankings video. So if you guys have been watching my channel for a while, you know that I love Pat McGrath eyeshadows and I have a pretty hefty collection of her palettes at this point. I have all but one of her motherships and I have a few of her other smaller palettes as well. And so I've been filming a lot of one-off videos with each of her palettes, and finally I thought it was time to kind of round them all up and give you guys my current ranking. So this video is actually a pretty big moment for both me and this channel in that when I first became interested in makeup reviews on YouTube, Pat McGrath rankings videos were one of the first types of videos that really caught my attention. Because as we all know, Pat McGrath eyeshadows are pretty pricey, and so if you're going to enter the realm of buying Pat McGrath eyeshadows, it really helps, in my opinion, to watch other people's ranking videos and get a good sense of how all of these palettes compare. So it really means a lot to me that you all have supported my channel and have requested this video, so thank you guys so much for watching. So as I mentioned at the top, I have all but one of Pat McGrath's mothership palettes, so I currently do not own Sublime yet. So I figured in this video I'd go ahead and rank all of my 11 Pat McGrath palettes, and eventually when I get Sublime I'll probably do a dedicated video just to the mothership palettes. It's a little bit unfair to compare the smaller palettes with the mothership palettes, but hopefully this is helpful for any of you who are looking into the smaller palettes as well. I also do want to disclaim that I love all of my Pat McGrath eyeshadow palettes, so even though today I'm ranking them, I do love all of them and use all of them on a regular basis. So if your favorite palette ends up in a low ranking, it doesn't mean I don't think it's an awesome palette. So since we have so many palettes to run through today, I won't be doing any swatches or demo in this video, but I have demoed all of these palettes in some of my other videos, so I'll provide links down below in case you guys are interested in swatches or a demo. For each of my review videos for Pat McGrath eyeshadow palettes, I do like using all of the shades just so you guys can see how they perform. And so for today's video, obviously I couldn't put all shades on my lids, but I actually used one shade from each palette, so I'll talk through those as we go along. But in case you're curious what's on my face today, it's actually a combination of all of these eyeshadow palettes. Without further ado, let's dive into these rankings. So to start off, here we have number 11. So this is the Fleur Fantasia Quad. And this came out last year in Pat McGrath's Celestial Divinity Holiday Collection. But for me, I think of this as being more of a spring palette. So I actually picked this up relatively recently as part of her spring VIP sales. And I got this for a steeply discounted price. So I only paid $30-some. And I would say that for the price that I paid for it, it's a really excellent quad. I really like in particular this lavender blue shade, which has a really beautiful dual chrome flip. And I also enjoy this iridescent orchid shade. And today I actually have this Lotus Paradise shade on my cheeks as a blush. So I put this down as an initial blush shade. So if you see a peachy tone on my cheeks, it's coming from this guy. And one thing I do really love about Pat McGrath's eyeshadows is that you can use them on the face as blush or highlight. So even though I think this is a really pretty spring palette and great if you can get it for a discount, it's ranking at the bottom of the pack just because this palette really doesn't have any depth to it. And so if you try to build a look just with these shades, it really won't provide you that much impact. So I find personally, whenever I use this palette, I do need to pair it with some of my other palettes. And then on top of that, even though these are all really beautiful pastel shades that create a very coherent spring color story, I would say that the shades don't necessarily blend together super well. So especially Iridescent Orchid doesn't really play super well with these other shades. And so that's a little bit unfortunate given that there are only four shades, so you'd think they would all work super well together. But that's why this palette is ranking last on my list. Next up, coming at number 10, is the Eternal Eden Quad. So this quad was recently released as part of Pat McGrath's Divine Rose 2 collection, and I really love the color story of this palette. I am a sucker for everything in her Divine Rose collection, so I was really excited when this came out. Unlike the other quad, you can definitely create a single coherent look with this quad. There's still not a ton of depth, but at least there's enough depth that you don't have to dip into another palette. This quad though is ranking towards the end though, in that I find this formula is just slightly less high quality compared to her other eyeshadows. So one thing to note with a lot of her quads is they do have different formulas oftentimes in comparison to her Mothership palettes. So for example, with this quad, these two mattes here actually are very different in formula compared to her other mattes. So these have kind of a silicone-y powder texture to them. And so on the one hand, they sheer out really, really easily on the lids. But on the other hand, they have the tendency to blend away a little bit. So it can be a little bit hard to build up the opacity with these matte shades. So I'm not a huge fan of that aspect. I do really like these other two shades though. I think they're really gorgeous. And especially this shade over here is basically like a more pigmented version of her Divine Rose highlighter. So this quad does pair really, really well with that highlighter. Overall, I do really like the color story of this, and I love dipping into this palette whenever I'm looking for a really pink look, but it just isn't as good in terms of quality or variety of looks in comparison to the other palettes that I'll talk about shortly. And for today's look, I actually use this pink shade over here called Temptation as a blush. So I concentrated this a little bit more on the apples of my cheeks, whereas Lotus Paradise is a little bit further back. But this is a really pretty pink flushed shade for that really nice, healthy blush look. Next up, coming in at number 9, we have the Golden Opulence palette. So I think this guy is already discontinued, so I'll keep it relatively short. But this was actually the first Pat McGrath palette I ever got that worked really well for me. So if you guys watched my Bronze Seduction video, you know that my first Pat McGrath palette was Bronze Seduction, but I got a dud version of that palette, and so I returned that. Didn't think that Pat McGrath was gonna work out for me. And then I picked this guy up for sale. So I think the original price is like $60 some, and I got it for $40 since I thought I might as well give Pat McGrath another shot. And I really fell in love with this as an everyday palette. This really has all the tones you need for a very simple everyday look. I would say this quad over here was really my gateway into luxury eyeshadows, because these were really the shades that I would always use on my lids on a daily basis. So I first started basically using this quad in place of my existing eyeshadows. And then I also really love these two at the end for just spicing up an everyday look. These 6 pans from Pat McGrath are also in this cardboard packaging, which is normally not a great thing. It's much cheaper looking in comparison to her black lacquer packaging, but this is excellent for travel. So if you're traveling and you're concerned about your eyeshadows breaking, this sort of packaging is really perfect for that. So I ended up getting a lot of use out of this palette and actually featured this in my best of 2020 makeup video. So you can check out that video if you want to see a demo with this palette. Like I said, I think this is discontinued at this point, but if for whatever reason you find this on eBay or something, I do think this is a really wonderful everyday palette from Pat McGrath. And the shadows just perform really impeccably. You're not gonna get any really fancy textured shadow in this sort of 6-pan format, but this was one of my most used Pat McGrath palettes from last year, just because the shadows are so great for an everyday basis. And today I have this shadow on my cheeks and in my inner corner as a highlight shade. And I chose this shade because when I first got this palette, this quickly became my favorite highlighter. In general, I really love Pat McGrath's Skin Show shades as highlighter. So now I have many to choose from, but this guy was kind of the OG in that category. So with the smaller palettes out of the way, let's get into these Motherships. So coming in at number 8 in my Pat McGrath palette rankings is the Decadence palette. And I don't actually have it here with me today, because if you guys watched my video on that palette, you know that the one that I ordered from Pat McGrath's website arrived with some bubbles in the Lapis Luxury shade. So I actually ended up returning that palette. I do plan though to buy that palette again the next time Pat McGrath has one of her big sales on her website. So that will be re-entering my collection soon. So I really like Decadence a lot in that it has such beautiful jewel toned and metal toned shades in the palette. And when you look at the box and when you look at the palette itself, it really feels like you just have this treasure box of eyeshadows to put on your lids. Also, even though when you first look at the palette, it might look like a bunch of shades that you already have, like golds and silvers and some jewel tones, each of the shades is actually quite unique in terms of the specific finish and shade. So for example, I really love Lapis Luxury. It's just one of the most beautiful bluish teal sky gemstone colors that I've seen in eyeshadows. I also really love Hedonistic, which is this gorgeous jewel chrome. So it just looks red or orange in the pan, but when you put it on your lids, you can see it has such a multi-dimensional effect. There's some yellow, there's some orange, there's some red, some pink as well. So I'm a huge fan of all of the shades in that palette. It's ranking though at the bottom of my mothership's list simply because I don't think Decadence is a palette that's that great to use just by itself. So you can definitely use it exclusively by itself and create some really gorgeous looks from it. But since it doesn't have any mattes and also doesn't have any of Pat McGrath's Blitz Astral formulas, you're not getting the full Pat McGrath experience through that palette. So if you're collecting Pat McGrath palettes, I would generally recommend picking up Decadence a little bit on the later side after you've already accumulated enough Pat McGrath palettes that you feel like you have enough of her mattes and special formulas. Decadence is basically going to expand the number of metallics and shimmers that you have in your collection. So a really great palette to dip into for specific shades, but not necessarily the best palette to use just by itself. Also, for me personally, when I think about what makes Pat McGrath palette so special, and especially what makes her mothership so special, it's definitely the Blitz Astral quads at the end of each palette. And so the fact that Decadence doesn't have that does just knock off some points for me. Next up, coming in at number 7 is Midnight Sun. So I'll say that for 6 and 7, I was going back and forth a lot. And honestly, this guy might move up in future rankings. Basically, I would say from this point onward, all of the palettes are just so great. It becomes much more of a matter of preference for color stories and shades rather than any sort of objective factors. So I really love how this palette has several different directions that you can take a look into. I would say that there's two dominant color stories within this. One is more of an earth tone collection. So especially if you look at the top 6, it's really a very warm, tawny, earthy type of color story. And so this set of 6 especially, I think, is just a perfect fall harvest kind of color story. And I anticipate using this palette a lot more come fall. The second color story though is in this quad down below, where you get much more of that kind of moonlight eyeshadow look. So especially this shade over here, which I actually put all over the inner 2/3 of my eye today, is just such a beautiful nighttime shade. And then when you combine it with any of these other Blitz Astral shades, you can either go sort of in a blood moon direction or a more standard moonlight direction. For this palette, I would say all of the shadows are really easy to work with, so that's something I really love about this. The only caveats though are that the vermilion shade over here is a little bit powdery and does take a little bit of building up in order to see the red shade. And also the blood moon shade over here is quite chunky, so you just have to be a little bit careful of glitter fallout when you're using this shade. And for me, I found myself reaching for this palette a lot, both for this taboo shade, which is just a perfect transition shade on my skin tone, and also Blitz Violet Orchid, which is just such a beautiful periwinkle violet shade. The reason this is ranking in at number 7 though is that this is just not the color story I've really been gravitating towards a lot recently. I think part of it is because I bought this in the spring and I think of this really as more of a fall color story. So my rankings might change a little bit come fall. Also, I do just feel like this palette is a little bit divergent in its color story, so it doesn't really yield as much of a cohesive look in comparison to my other palettes. So for example, for both the Skin Show shade and the Astral Solstice shade, they bring in a strong white glow to the look, which I think contrasts a lot with a lot of these other shades, which are much more earthy in tone. Also, there's just a lot of colors in this palette. You really almost have a complete rainbow. So you have your red, your orange, your yellow, your green, your bluish purple, so on and so forth. And so in that sense, I often find myself dipping into this palette just for one or two shades to combine with another palette rather than just building a look around this palette by itself. Next up, coming in at number 6, is the Bronze Seduction palette. And honestly, it's kind of surprising to me that this palette is ranking so high, because this is the palette that originally broke my heart around Pat McGrath eyeshadows. The first version of this palette I got was a complete dud. It had tons of quality issues, so I had to return it, and for a while thereafter did not buy any Pat McGrath eyeshadows until I eventually picked up the Golden Opulence palette. And so I recently picked this palette up again for the purposes of doing this ranking, because I wanted to just check to make sure whether I still felt the same way about this palette. Unfortunately for me, this newer version of the palette does not have as many quality issues as the previous one I got, so this guy has definitely moved up in the rankings as a result. Some of you though might still be surprised that this is ranking relatively low, because this is such a crowd favorite and this got the Allure Best of Beauty eyeshadow 1 year. So I think this palette plays a big role in the Pat McGrath fandom, just because a lot of folks first discovered Pat McGrath eyeshadows through this palette becoming really famous. So for me personally, I can see why this palette is so popular, in that if you just look at it, it's one of the most neutral color stories from Pat McGrath, and it has these really approachable shades along with a few really standout shades like this VR Fire Opal. For me, I really love this palette primarily for these three shades at the end. So ever since I got this palette, I found myself constantly reaching for it, especially for this rose gold shade over here, which is just the perfect mix of being a tone that is relatively neutral and everyday, but the shade is also just so high shine and so creamy and beautiful. So I've really been loving this shade a lot. Also, VR Fire Opal is probably my favorite Blitz Astral shade across all of my Pat McGrath palettes, which is saying a lot, because as I mentioned before, the Blitz Astral shades to me are really what are super special and interesting about Pat McGrath eyeshadows. So the fact that this guy beat out Midnight Sun is really saying a lot about how much I love these three shades down here. I would say the other shades are fine, but just don't attract me as much. In particular, I would say the mattes are slightly difficult to work with, at least in comparison to my other Pat McGrath mattes. Today, I actually have this Extreme Aubergine shade as the deepest shade in the outer third of my eye, and I've actually been dipping into this palette a lot for that shade. Not because it's the easiest to work with, but just because I do really like purpley looks, and so it just so happens that Extreme Aubergine is the deepest purple shade throughout all of the Pat McGrath palettes. In terms of the metallics in this palette, I would say this shade over here is a little bit of a dud. It's pretty difficult to pick up with a brush and also a little bit challenging to build up with a finger. So it's a really pretty cool tone bronzy shade, but not one that I pick up a lot. This bronze over here is a much better quality and is quite easy to use. I just don't particularly reach for that kind of shade very often. And then this red shade over here is solid, but does take a little bit of building up in order to get opacity. So overall, I would say that this palette for me has been the most variable from a quality perspective, but these three at the bottom are definitely a home run. Next up, in fifth place, we have the Subversive palette. And so this one was actually quite a surprise to me in terms of how much I love this palette. And indeed, I was debating for the longest time whether to rank this higher. And so don't be surprised if this guy also possibly moves up in the rankings later on. But what I love about this palette is the shimmers are all such high impact shades. So when I first got this palette, I was a little bit concerned because the formulas of this palette are very different from the formulas in the rest of my Pat McGrath palettes. So the mattes are comparable, but I would say that these two metallics plus these four Blitz Astral shades are all much more shiny and textured in comparison to her other palettes. And so when I first got this, I was a little bit worried because I felt like the formulas were a little bit chunky. There was more glitter fallout in comparison to the other palettes. But once I started creating looks around this palette, I quickly fell in love. Because even though these shadows are a little bit more textured and thus need a little bit more care in order to avoid fallout, the effect is just so beautiful and high impact. And so I found myself just really gravitating to this palette a lot for these two plus these four shades in particular. I honestly haven't used these other four shades all that often. I would say that these two mattes are a little bit deep by themselves for me to use without combining them with a transition shade from another Pat McGrath palette. So if I'm dipping out for other mattes, I often just end up using another palette's mattes entirely. Also, these two satin shimmer shades are both very solid, but just not shades I've been gravitating towards a lot. But the rest of the shades are all so beautiful for a standout Pat McGrath look. And today I actually have this Blitz Amethyst shade all over the center of my lids. So I layered this on top of the Periwinkle shade from the Midnight Sun palette. And then just for some extra dimension and sparkle, I actually also went into this Astral Ghost Orchid shade, which I was on the fence about when I first got this palette, because this shade is really different from her other glitter topper shades in that it doesn't really have any pigmentation to itself. It's kind of like an iridescent unicorn skin formula where it basically adds a lot of texture and reflectivity to your lids, but it doesn't actually have any base pigment in and of itself. And so it looks slightly different depending on what you layer it on top of, and it can be a little bit flaky and fall off your lids if you don't have any sort of glitter glue on. But I do really love this shade a lot. It just adds so much dimension and so much shine, and it's especially beautiful if you have either a pink, purple, or blue look. This VR pink shade is also a lot of fun. It has a pink to orange flip to it. So I love jazzing up any look with this guy. And then Gigabyte is also just such a perfect olive green, khaki, golden shade. It just looks so rich and beautiful on the lids. So I've been having a lot of fun with this palette, and even though I rarely use this palette for an entire look, I usually find myself dipping into this palette whenever I want a really standout Pat McGrath look. My left arm is getting a little bit tired, so now let's switch to my right hand side. So coming in at number four is the Pat McGrath Subliminal palette. And this was the first Mothership palette that I ever got that I really, really fell in love with. And this palette has played a really important role in my own makeup evolution, in that this palette really made me realize that makeup artistry is something that can be attainable if you have the right tools at your disposal. And so whenever I dip into this palette, I'm just so impressed with the looks that it gives me, because it just makes it so easy to create a look that is so beautiful, so intergalactic, and so out of my comfort zone normally. So before I bought this palette, I wasn't very comfortable with cool toned eyeshadows, and I was definitely not comfortable with blue. But this one has really changed all of that and really set me on this path that I'm currently on of trying out all of these fun, colorful looks with all sorts of high-end and luxury eyeshadows. So this palette really has a special place in my heart. I also love that this palette has such a coherent color story, such that whenever I pick up this palette, even though it might look a little bit intimidating with that blue shade, I find myself often using all of the shades in this palette. And for today's look, I put this lavender shade on my lower lash line in the inner two-thirds, and then topped it with this astral white shade, which just brings that really beautiful blue sparkle to the look. And in addition to loving the looks I get from this palette as a whole, I also think this is such an excellent palette to use in conjunction with other Pat McGrath palettes. So when I first got this palette and tried this Ultimate Taupe shade, I didn't really think it looked like anything on my skin, and so I didn't really like that shade. I was like, okay, well, here's a shade that really has no color payoff if you're medium to tan. But I actually find myself dipping into this palette just for that shade very often, skin, because even though it doesn't show up a ton on my skin, it's perfect for achieving a really nice gradient. Since it's so light, it's just the perfect base to set down before you go in with a mid-tone or deep matte shade. And so if you start with this guy, it'll just make your blend so easy. And also it'll just add a nice haze to the edge of the gradient. So I really love Ultimate Taupe. And then also, I really love this Extreme Black shade. So I know that this is also in Subversive, but for some reason, the one in this palette in particular just works so easily for me. So prior to getting this palette, I was always not very good at using the black matte shades and palettes because I just found it was really hard for me to blend them out. But once I picked this guy up and used this Extreme Black, I just found it was so easy to blend out and also just blended into these other two matte shades so perfectly, and that it really was game changing for me, especially because having a black base to your eyeshadow can be really excellent if you want your shimmers to really pop. So I really love this Extreme Black shade. Also, even though I have a lot of eyeshadow combinations from Pat McGrath that I'm a huge fan of at this point, I think still my overall favorite combo is probably Blitz Blue plus Astral White on top of it. So Astral White might look really boring in the pan, especially because also its name is Astral White, so you'd think it's just a white shade. But actually it has a really beautiful light blue flip to it. And so when you put it on top of Blitz Blue, it's just the most gorgeous blue color. This deep ocean blue plus this light shimmery blue on top. So it's really ethereal and super gorgeous. So I love using that combination from this palette. I will say though, I don't usually use this palette by itself on an everyday basis, which is one of the reasons it's ranking slightly lower than my top few. But this palette has been such a game changer for me and just such an important part of my collection. So coming in at number 3, which might come as a surprise, is the Celestial Divinity Mothership Mega Palette. And yes, we have just gone through a bunch of Mothership palettes, but I would actually rank this one above most of my Mothership palettes. And I know that might be an unpopular opinion given that this is in a cardboard packaging and is only $78 in comparison to the $125 for the Mothership palettes. But I just love this palette so much. I think it is such a fun palette and honestly a great place to start out if you just want a bunch of Pat McGrath eyeshadows for a comparatively affordable price. I mean, considering the packaging, it still is quite expensive, but the quality of the shadows are truly Pat McGrath quality. And for me, whenever I open this palette, I just feel really inspired to create some new and interesting looks. This palette really has everything you need, from some mid-toned matte shades, and today I actually have this Venomous Void shade all over the outer third and crease area of my eye. And then it has so many different kinds of shimmers that you can play with. It has ones that are more glitter toppers, it has ones that are dual chrome, ones that are just really creamy metallics, ones that are super high shine, ones that are more finely milled that you can use in lieu of a matte. So this is just such a fun palette, and I find that using this by itself, I can create such a wide variety of looks. And also, I just really love the curation of this palette. So this actually is basically like 3 6-pan palettes put in one. So over here we have the Dark Galaxy Star Wars 6-pan, and then we have the Galactic Gold Star Wars 6-pan, and then we have these 6 shades in the middle that were added exclusive to this palette, but really just round out the palette. I'm not sure how much longer this palette will be available, so definitely pick it up if you haven't already. I would highly recommend this if you like to play around with color. Alrighty, so now we are down to our final 2, and you guys can probably guess already what these guys are. But coming in 2nd place is the Divine Rose 1 palette. And for me, I was actually quite surprised that this would rank so high, because when I first saw this palette, I thought it looked incredibly boring and really not up my alley, because I like more neutral and warm tones typically. I also like more colorful looks. And so when I first looked at this, I was like, okay, I don't think this is gonna work out. But I actually picked this up because I was so enamored with Divine Rose 2 and figured I'd pick up her sister as well. And this one has quickly risen to be one of my favorite eyeshadow palettes of all time. So what I love about this palette is it has such a beautiful, cohesive color story that can go either very everyday or also very sultry glam. And even though these tones might look a lot more muted in comparison to her other Mothership palettes, there's something about the specific undertones and the textures such that the look that you make is just so elegant and beautiful, even though it might not be as immediately eye-catching in comparison to the other palettes, but it just has that really gorgeous, chic, understated elegance. And you can also really glam it up with using Astral Solstice, which really just transforms your lids into a disco ball. So I am a huge fan of basically using all of these shades on my lids. I would say though, also like Subliminal, I really like dipping into this palette just for specific shades. So for example, today I started my eyeshadow look with Valoria. So basically this shade provided the base for all of my other eyeshadows. And similar to Ultimate Taupe, when I first tried this shade, I thought it was just too light on my skin tone because it really didn't show up a ton. But I found since then that, especially if I build it up, it provides such a beautiful transition shade and makes all other shades just blend really beautifully on top of it. So whenever I'm doing more of a purpley look, I love starting out with this shade. I also really like how this iridescent pink shade just adds a really beautiful pink flip to anything, so you can really easily make something look like it's slightly dual chrome by integrating the shade. It's also a very unique formula in that it's not shimmery in comparison to a lot of her other Blitz Astral formulas. So it just adds this subtle sheen, but very noticeable flip. Lovelace and Rose Dusk are also just such wonderful creamy metallic shades. They blend out on the lids so beautifully and just add a really lovely lilac pinky hue to the lids. I would say the only shade I'm not a huge fan of in this palette is ironically the VR Rose Venus shade, which is in theory the standout shade because that's the dual chrome, but I just don't like how it looks just golden on my lids. I think maybe if you have a really big eye area, then you can see the flip, but I find that it's really hard to see anything other than the gold when I put it on my lids. And as much as the gold is pretty, it's just kind of disappointing to me because I would think these two shades would be pretty different on the lids. But in my experience, the VR Rose Venus just kind of looks golden. So that's the one thing I'm not a huge fan of in this palette. But overall, I just really love all the looks that I create with this palette. And whenever I have this on my lids, I just find myself really admiring how all of the shadows play together. So last off, perhaps no surprise to any of you who have been watching my videos, but number one for me has to be Divine Rose 2. So I am absolutely in love with and obsessed with this palette. So I would say that the shades in this palette just really, really speak to me. So whereas some of the other palettes I really love because they've kind of stretched me out of my comfort zone, this one is the perfect mix of some shades that do kind of encourage me to step a little bit out of my comfort zone, but also just so many shades that really just speak to me and what I like in eyeshadows. So first and foremost, let's talk about Sepsiterrestrial. So this is definitely my favorite shade in this palette and possibly my favorite Pat McGrath eyeshadow in general. So this is her first and so far only multi-chrome shade. So it has a rose, peach, chartreuse flip to it. I love how it's so easy to work with. It just glides on the skin so nicely, but it also just provides such a beautiful flip. Whenever I have this on my lids, I always find myself just kind of moving my face around in the mirror and seeing the shade change. And I love how also, in contrast to VR Rose Venus, I can actually see all three shades in the flip when I put this all over my eyes. So it's not like it only shows up as one shade, even though my eyes aren't that large. I also really love this Eleganza shade. It is also one of my favorite Pat McGrath shadows in that it's just so foiled and metallic on the lids and such a beautiful shade. It really has that rose, lilac, silver tone to it. So if you want something a bit more cool tone from this palette, I would definitely recommend going into Eleganza and maybe pairing it with Valoria and some of the shades from Divine Rose One. That's a beautiful look if you want something ever so slightly cooler in tone. I also really love Naked Blush as the initial transition shade. This is probably my favorite matte from Pat McGrath's collection, just because I find it so flattering on my skin tone. It's something that makes my skin tone look quite natural and healthy, but also has that slight contrast that makes it look kind of spring-like and vibrant. So I love this guy, and it can also be used as a lovely blush as well. Speaking of blush, Rose Seduction is also a great blush. It's such a beautiful fuchsia pink with a slight satin shimmer to it. So it looks really healthy on the skin as a blush shade. You can also use it in lieu of a matte on the lids. So I also love using Rose Seduction as my initial transition shade and then building up some depth with some matte shades on top. For today's look, I had the Skin Show Rose Opal shade as my brow bone highlight and also layered it in the inner corner as well. And this is probably my favorite Skin Show shade in that it has such a beautiful pink flip. And I've been on the search for a good highlighter that has a nice pink flip to it. And I found it's actually surprisingly difficult to find one that isn't just like pink glitter, but has like a pink reflect to it. And so this one really delivers. In terms of my entire collection, I would say that this is definitely the best pink highlighter if you want something that actually has the pink flip rather than just pink base pigment. Astral Pink Moon is also one of my favorite astral shades. So even though it's called Pink Moon, the actual shade is a little bit more rose gold in terms of the glitter, but I find that it just goes well with really a wide variety of looks. And especially I love layering this on top of Sextraterrestrial. It just has enough of that pinky peachiness such that it melds well with the rosy peach in Sextraterrestrial. So if you want that really beautiful glitter shine, but you have an eyeshadow on that has a little bit more pink, yellow, orange, bronze, then I think this Astral Pink Moon is great on top of that. And then finally, I would say Extreme Burgundy is a really excellent deepening shade. So prior to getting Bronze Seduction, whenever I wanted something that was a little bit purpley for my deepest shade, I would always go for this shade over here. And I would say that this shade is a lot easier to work with compared to the deepest shades in a lot of her other palettes, including in comparison to Extreme Aubergine. The rest of the shades, so these two over here and this guy over here, are all really beautiful. I have nothing bad to say about them. They're just not shades I personally pick up a ton. I have a lot of golds and a lot of bronzes in my collection. As you can tell, basically Pat McGrath always features a gold and a bronze in each of her palettes. I would say of the bronzes, this bronze rosé shade over here is definitely one of my favorites, so I'll give it points for that, just because it does have more of a rosy undertone to it and doesn't run as gold, brown, or orange as some of the other bronzes. But overall, I don't use bronze a ton, so just gonna add that caveat there. And then when it comes to Divine Dusk, I like dipping into this if I'm doing a full look with this palette, but it is quite similar to Eleganza, so if I'm dipping into this palette just for one or two shades, then Eleganza will definitely be the one. So overall, I really love this palette and would highly recommend it to anyone who is looking to pick up their first Pat McGrath palette. In general, I would say if you like more muted, cool tones, then I would recommend Divine Rose One. If you like more neutral tones and aren't a huge fan of pinky purple shades, then I would recommend Subliminal as a first Pat McGrath palette. But if you have similar preferences to me and really like rosy, colorful springtime looks, then Divine Rose 2 is definitely the way to go. So that's it for my ranking video. I hope that this was helpful for you guys. Definitely let me know down below if you have any questions about any of these palettes. And also, I'd be really curious to hear from all of you what your favorite Pat McGrath palette is. As I mentioned at the top, today's ranking was really based on how I use these palettes and what my personal preferences are. Let me know if you guys would be interested in a video that's more about which Mothership palette I would recommend for what kind of person, because I could definitely do something like that that would be a little bit more recommendations oriented. Also, if you guys like these Pat McGrath rankings videos, please let me know down below. My plan is when I eventually pick up the Sublime palette, hopefully it'll go on sale some point. I want to basically film a follow-up to this video that ranks all of the Mothership palettes. And hopefully also in the meantime, she comes out with another Mothership. So let me know if you guys would be interested in that kind of video. And also I've been toying around with the idea of possibly filming a swatch comparison video across all the Motherships. So basically, for example, swatching all of the brown tones, all of the bronze tones, all of the purple tones, so on and so forth in color category, just so if you guys are debating between them and see some shades that look sort of similar across the palettes, you can see them swatched side by side just to get a better sense of how the shades compare. So let me know if you guys think that would be interesting or helpful to you. But thank you guys so much for joining me in today's video. This video is really quite special to me because I really never thought I would be one of those folks who has enough of a Pat McGrath collection to do a Pat McGrath rankings video. So I really appreciate all the support you all have given my channel, and thank you especially to all of you who have commented in my videos, especially those of you who encouraged me to do a ranking video. Whenever I upload a video, it kind of feels like it just goes off into the ether. So I always really appreciate seeing your guys' comments, your likes, so on and so forth, because it makes me feel like folks are engaging with the content and that you guys are finding these videos helpful. So if you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll catch you next time. Bye!